original fur white wood on it.
Okay. Keep moving.
We got a lot done in one day. We took this from a totally empty shell, you know, we got from the dealership. We put in the subwalls, sub-ceiling, sub-floors. We started mocking up aircraft tables, air conditioning cabinets, J-lounges. We can go ahead and start tearing apart tomorrow. Pre-wire, insulate. Beginning of something beautiful here.
And as the CMI team prepares to get back to work, Bill and his crew with Bear Creek Carpentry are nearing the complete of their current tiny house project. For Bear Creek, building these tiny houses is a family affair. Apart from Joe, the lead carpenter, Bill works side by side with his three sons.
I work with my sons around me and my daughter. It's nothing like it. This type of work is probably my favorite work I've ever done. It's the most rewarding feeling, just stepping back at the end of the day and just seeing like the progress.
I've been going to the job ever since I was born. You could probably call me the building rat. I would crawl underneath the building because I was the smallest person on the job.
This supports the upstairs sleeping loft, is what it does.
We're using a lot of really big, really strong fasteners.
Roll 900 pounds, so we put hundreds in there, so obviously it's way stronger than necessary.
This is the sleeping loft, and this is Douglas Fir Tongue Group, bottom floor.
We put the fir floor down before we frame the roof. That would be really, really hard to do if the roof was in first. You'd never be able to swing the hammer. That's through experience.
This piece is the centerboard. And we nail the rafters straight to this.
It might take a normal customer up to 800 hours to build one of these tiny houses. But for Bear Creek, it only takes about 200.
We're about 85% framed.